Alright guys, Weebud here. We're online for panel eventually at 1:30 and inside look at Devil May Cry 5. Decided to go here. It is now barely 10 a.m. Early for the line, not early for the game demos. For some reason, not even 10 a.m. Kingdom Hearts 3 ran out of tickets. DMC5 line is capped. So I wanted to rush here to at least make sure I got this, because it's crazy packed already. And it's not even 10 a.m. Fuck going to the weekend next year. Thursday, Friday, Comic-Con's way too busy now. This is ridiculous. So, looking forward to showing you the panel. Weebud out.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I wanna be a part of it.
So Izuno-san himself, we've done a couple conventions here, but it's been amazing. He's been so moved being able to come here, actually meet you guys, meet the fans. And everybody's coming up saying, hey, can I get a picture? Can I shake your hand? And it's been incredible. You know, we're so happy and so lucky, you know, that you guys are as passionate as you are about the game. And that's why we do. We do it. We make these games specifically so that you guys will hopefully enjoy it. We're ecstatic that you guys are as excited as you are.
Awesome. So we have a lot of hardcore fans here, some true fans. For everyone else, maybe some of the people who might be watching later, can you tell the audience a little bit about your role on the Devil May Cry 5 team?
ディレクターとしてですね、まあ、シナリオキャラクター考えてゲームも、もう 技とかシステムとかも一番全体を見るタイプのディレクターをやっています。
So as you guys can tell, he's the director of the game, and what that means is he looks over everything related to the game, whether we're talking about the scenario, whether we're talking about the characters, whether we're talking about the different moves. He looks at all that stuff, he thinks about a lot of that stuff, and he gives feedback and gives ideas for all that stuff. So he really does look over everything. And then I'm the producer on the game, and I do a lot of stuff as well. I don't look at the creative as much as he does. I manage a lot of the creation of the card assets, so a lot of the models. We scan all the different people for the characters, for instance, and creating a lot of the environments as well. I looked over a lot of that, and then I also now work a lot on coordinating with everybody, whether it's in development or whether it's in kind of publishing, or whether it's even just going back and forth with CUSA and CE, Capcom USA and Capcom Europe.
You have to deal with me like all the time.
All the time, it's great. It's pretty sweet. We haven't gotten glitter cannons yet, but I'm hoping.
Yeah. Are you letting me have glitter cannons?
Dude, let's do the glitter cannons. All right.
So, all right. I just can't help it sometimes. So this is a fun question. So for both of you, who is your favorite character in the whole Devil May Cry series and why?
ゲームパックだっけ、パックスではバージョンで、今ずっと遊んでてチェックしてて、めっちゃ面白いのは V です。V はね、V 結構強いんですよ。まあ、それ中身で楽しみにしてください。
So at PAX we were asked this question, Isamu-san originally said Virgil, and lately he's been doing a lot of play checks on the game, and he's like, you know what, right now my favorite character is V, actually.
Oh. So,
why is that? Why is he your favorite character? He says, well, he's really strong, and we can't talk about it yet. playing, it feels so good. For me, I think I said the same thing at PAX, but I just... Dante is the OG man. Yeah. And we've seen so much of Dante throughout the series. We've seen him evolve, you know, we've seen him grow and see him, you know, for young Dante in DMC 3 and then moving through the series, and now we have an older Dante in DMC 5. You know, it's really cool to see how he's developed and see how he's kind of grown as a person, you know.
Ooh. All right, badass. So something that's coming up in the deluxe edition and for pre-order. So we have these really cool alternate costumes for some of our main characters. Can you tell us a little bit about those? So first we got, speaking in OG, we got Dante and we got Nero here. Can you tell us a little bit about the inspiration of these?
Dante, もう僕が DMC デビルメイクライのことを別に忘れてないですよっていう意味で、DMC デビルメイクライのなんてかなで、ネロは教団騎士のからですね、かっこいいと思います。
So for Dante, the inspiration behind Dante was basically it was our way of we wanted to pay homage to DMC Devil May Cry because we loved that game and we think it was awesome. So that's what that is. And then for Nero, it goes back to the kind of the whole idea of the Knight of the Order, the Holy Knight from DMC4. That's where that comes from.
Cool. And we also have our heroines too, right here. Woo!
Lady.
Nico は何カラーっていうのはあれなんですけど、こういうニコもみんな好きじゃないのと思ってこのカラーにしてみました。で、トリシュはブロディアカラーですね。で、レディはトリシュカラーですね。トリシュ
I was there. So for Nico, that was kind of our way of going, you know what, if we became an alternate version of Nico, what would she look like? And we kind of thought about it, we thought, all right, this would be kind of cool. This would be kind of a cool color scheme for her. For Trish there, we have an homage to Gloria. And then for Lady, it's an homage to Trish. That's where that comes from.
That's very circular in that way. Oh, they look so cool. Like, I especially love that lady look. Oh, that was so nice. Now, speaking of cool imagery, I want to know if Ikuno-san, if you could talk a little bit about some of the new modes you can expect in DMC 5, such as the photo mode that I believe we are debuting here today.
Oh.
Right?
Selfies.
Second roll take. Alright, let's look at it. Woo!
Selfies.
So you can jump
into photo
mode anytime. Oh! Nice! Woo! So you made like 6 shots there. That's the dev team having too much fun with making assets.
Woo!
So yeah, you guys, that's photo mode, and you'll be able to pause it anytime during the game and do this. So hopefully we'll see people post a lot of awesome screens from Devil May Cry on all our social media.
So you can get your best shot after you take your best shot. So speaking of Dante, let's move on. So one of the this is so cool, guys. We are actually doing a deep dive into Dante's weaponry in Devil May Cry 5. So again for the team, so can you tell us a little bit about Dante in Devil May Cry 5?
Alright, so for Dante here, he's got a lot of different weapons at his disposal. We're about to show you guys some weapons you've seen before, but also some weapons that we're showing for the first time here. Well, as you guys can see, it's the Ebony and Ivory that everybody loves. Everyone loves. And in that video, you can see that we have gallery mode where you'll be able to take a look at the weapons, all the weapons, and turn them around like that. Take a view. And interestingly, so the idea behind Ebony and Ivory was that they would kind of have different characteristics. One was going to be more powerful, and one was going to have a higher firing rate. So we've actually implemented that as well.
Gunslinger.
So try them out with Gunslinger and see what happens. Is there anything you want to say about it? I want people to look at the video. All right, let's check it out.
Don't
have to really pay attention to the animations and stuff. So there's this theory that he's doing anime for what he's using it during these different animations that he's triggered it during. Check it out. So the idea, the reason that it's Kalina Ann 2, not Kalina Ann, is because, well, as you guys know, Kalina Ann is a lady, that's hers. So she asked Nico to make Dante. And Nico tried her best to create a Kalina Ann, Kalina Ann that was going to match that lady. So we have a lot of new stuff for Kalina Ann 2 to show, but we'll save that for later.
Ready for some swordplay. We have...
はい、おなじみリベリオンなんですけど、フォーマルとはちょっとだけデザインが変わってますね。
It's the rebellion that everybody knows and loves, but if you pay attention, you'll be able to see that we've updated the design a little bit since DMC4.
So
the idea is that this was derived from the Force Edge, right? The Force Edge is actually technically part of this. And up through DMC4, we had always used the same PS2 model that the Force Edge is now. And you know, it's PS2, so the polygon count is really low. So it was starting to look pretty bad. And so we basically remade this weapon with the idea that, all right, we're going to make the Force Edge finally look, you know, better than up to date with the target.
Let's see
it
in action.
What? Oh!
As you see, it transforms into three different forms here. We have the ice on ducks, and then we have the fire bow that it turns into. And then the lightning chain stuff, money stuff thing. I'm sure there's a proper term for that.
Pizza cutters.
That's cool, man. You know, it's the first time. This is actually the first time where we've really shown off how they look when they're separated like that. So that's pretty cool. And as you can see, it's essentially dual-wielding chainsaws, more or less.
But you can also ride, right?
And you can also ride, exactly.
Yeah. It does double duty. All right, let's see it in action.
Smoking sick.
Showing off there, bad Cavalier skills. Being Cavalier about it in the process. So if, when you're going to want to ride the bike like that, you'll be doing that when you're a Swordmaster, so keep that in mind. That's how you'll be able to pull off the stick. Riding moves. Showing off like what they look like separate, you know, from when Dante's wearing
them.
You can actually, the way they're set up there, you can see when they kind of sit together like that, they kind of form the face of the Balrog. Nobody's ever seen a Balrog and doesn't get cried before, but this is what it would look like.
All right, let's see it in action.
Godhead mode.
There's two modes, right? So, okay, here you switch to the kick mode, which is kind of more of this capoeira style, whereas the other mode is more of a boxing style. If you actually pay attention, you'll see that he's got these shoulder pads that when he's in blow mode, they're gonna basically become these kind of brass knuckles on the gauntlets on his arms. And then when he goes to kick mode, they actually transfer down to his legs.
イグニッションっていう技でして、プロモードの場合は空振りでもいいんで10回殴ると、イグニッションもできるし、キックモードの時は、カポエラを。
And maybe you're wondering, like, okay, what's the fire? Like, how does that work? Well, you see that as he's punching in warmload there, whether you're connected with the punch or not, that fills up the fire. That's called, there's a move called ignition. And when you're in kick mode, you do a little, I'm not going to do the dance thing, but the little capoeira dance, when you do that, that's how that powers up ignition.
Oh, that looks so cool. It looks like he's like almost like doing like a shoryuken.
リアルインパクトはアフローモードで一番ヒートアップした状態で、ライジングドラゴンするとリアルインパクト。
So that's a move called Breathing Impact. And what'll happen is when you build up ignition like that all the way to its max, low mode, that's when you can do that move, the one that looks like a shimshu
you. Really cool. Oh my god, it's so cool. And so this next one I think is totally new for the audience as well.
Ooh.
And I think it's actually got one of the coolest mechanics in the game.
Check out what
this is an exclusive look at that we never
really did.
So, as you can see here, this is a hat.
It's quite a hat.
So, you didn't see the eyes there. So, there's an enemy in DMCZ4 called the Faust. So, this is weaponized form of the Faust. So, as you can see, he's got the eyes here. And it's... This is an interesting weapon. Let's see what it looks like when you're fighting.
All right, it is very interesting.
Oh! What?
What? Tien?
Oh!
Cappy?
Wait a minute.
See, there's kind of two parts to the weapon now. There's the hat, and then...
What?!
And then he's got the scarf that is kind of based on the cape that Faust had in the MC4.
で、そう、絵を見て悩んだのは、これは、この時はね、自分が食べた冷凍をぶつける。っていう、ですね。で、レッドをぶつけると、持ってる冷凍をヘルカワにすんげえ強い。で、さっきのインスティングできたやつも、 貯めればためるほど、でっかい隕石が出てくるし、めっちゃめちゃお金減るんですけど、もう一つ、あ、まずそれだけ言おうか。もう一つ言うと、このね、ハットを投げて、敵に被らせた状態で攻撃すると、すっげえいっぱいレッドも出てくるんですよ。だから、レッドもたくさん使うんだけども、レッドもたくさん儲けるための武器でも。So,
as you can see, he's got all these crazy moves with this, and the way it works is there's supposed to be a risk and reward with it. So, like this move, for instance, here, you use your red orbs to use this.
Oh.
And you can also, what will happen is you can use red orbs, and like for instance, that meteorite move, that's gonna use a ton of red orbs. But with this weapon, the other thing you can do is if you attack with that throw, the way he throws the hat, you beat an enemy with that, you get a ton of red orbs back.
So the
idea is, you want to use this, and you want to use them with that move, because that way you're going to get a ton of red back.
Huh.
And the idea with that hat throw move is you're marking the enemy. So,
you can attack the enemy with Redorks, but because it's this risk of reward thing, what will happen is if you attack with the hat and you get attacked by that enemy, you're going to lose Redorks as you get attacked.
Oh.
And the length of the scarf is dependent on how many Red Orbs you have in your inventory. So the more Red Orbs you have, the longer it's going to be. With all that stress that's built up from being as Nero is gone fighting demons. And what will happen is when you hit the B button, or the circle button, the Sweet Surrender is going to vibrate. Well, it's going to move like this. And as it moves, you're going to get just a tiny bit of health back if you're in battle. And it doesn't have any kind of offensive ability at all. So it's very much, okay. But you have to be careful because, okay, so you don't have any attack ability with this, but as you're using it, if you take a hit, it's going to break. And so, yeah, as I mentioned earlier, it doesn't, but you can only get health back with that if you're in the middle of battle. So, and that also, again, there's supposed to be a balance here, so. That also means that you only have two weapons to fight with now, as Nero. You're not able to fight with Devilbreaker and do your combo with Blue Rose and Red Queen. Now you only have Blue Rose and Red Queen because you're not actually going to be able to attack with this one. And your only other option with Sweet Surrender there is if you do the breakage move, where you charge up the B button and then let go of it, you'll do a super heal that'll heal about 3 bars there, but then Sweet Surrender is going to break. So you have to think long and hard about, okay, is this something I want to do? So really, the applications for that might actually be more for people that are playing the really hard modes and they're really trying to kind of brute force their way through.